afternoon at the Curtis car. Curtis Craft Vintage. And a 1949 Curtis Craft Vintage. It's a beautiful black car behind the vintage. Classic V8 Ford 60. Also tonight, we're going to see the 1984 Opal car. That car ran on Thursday night, but you may remember it. Car number 21, now moving into turn number 3, driven by Chuck Gurney, Chris Boker, Billy Vukovich III, Randy Tolga, and Joe Saldana. A very prominent car back in those days in the 80s on Thursday night. But, you know, there's really a lot to this business of vintage race car restoration. There's fun and camaraderie, both on and off the track, as well as, you can imagine, some frustration. The cars often must be pieced together, reformed after years of neglect. This can be a really painstaking process. In many cases, there are hundreds of hours in the restoration process, as well as significant expense. There are just a couple of reasons. That's just a couple of reasons. Early tonight, we offer only exhibition laps, all yellow flag laps, part rolls, and we dare not attempt to begin the strain of competition. Still, this is a beautiful sight. You see these cars span of multiple eras on parade. Let's take a look at some of the cars now on the track. That white car number 7 is another Curtis Craft Vintage. That particular car is, let me take a look here, a 1946 Curtis Craft. And also in turn 3, I'd like to point out that is the World of Outlaws champion car. The car that won $100,000 in Eldora. Jack Huntschild, the wild child, the driver back in the early 90s. The car has just been restored. Car number 22. The driver is Jay Wolf in Indiana. And also on the back stretch, that car number 7, that roadster, that is reminiscent of Johnny Thompson's 1960 Indianapolis 500 roadster. Terry Channel driver, taking it easy so you can see it really, really well. Beautiful car. And that is a Curtis Craft replica roadster. Stock cars also on the track tonight. Car number 8, David Dennis. If you remember stock car racing from old, probably the early, everybody had a coupe, and most of those were Chevrolet. This is a 1935 Chevrolet. Car number 8, David Dennis, driver. And car number 1, that white number 1, moving into the first turn, that is the Fight Plumbing replica. Parnelli Joe won the 1961 Sprint Car Championship in a car that is very similar to the car that's on the track right now. Car number 1. Here it is in front of the main grandstand. The flank. This is Bike Plumbing Special. We also have a Silver Crown car number 15. That red number 15 in car number 1. That is a 1980 J&J chassis. Chevrolet 350. Car built for Hank Carlson. If you were around in the early 80s or maybe the late 80s and into the early 90s, Bill Bowie, Jerry Niemeyer was the driver of that car. Car number 15. These are the cars that ran on Spickle, Des Moines, Springfield, and Indianapolis. The original Silver Crown cars. Car number 15 on the track. We're just spotlighting some of the cars that are out here this afternoon. Hope you got to take a look at them earlier today. Car number 43, car number 43 in the third turn. That car was driven by Tom Bigelow back today. That car number 43 driven by Ken Muller tonight. That's a 1985 Gold. So we spotlighted some of the important cars and the interesting cars tonight. You know, we're always pleased to be invited here to Tri-State Speedway. With its history tonight celebrating 60 years, this entire business of vintage race cars is really growing. In May, I think for the fifth year, there were vintage race cars on the track for 3 days at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway leading up to the Indianapolis 500. In June, there were many more cars in the NPIMS, hundreds of race cars on the track. And this is the fourth year for that event, and what most people believe is the premier racetrack around the world. If you're are familiar with the Milwaukee Trial, they're designed program is coming in 4 days, and I believe it's starting there. The Harry Miller Award, presentation of the Miller cars that celebrate the craftsmanship of Harry Miller at the Milwaukee Mile. The same cars you see today will also make stops this summer at other historic tracks, the Terre Haute Action Track, the historic High Bank Salem Speedway, and it's our pleasure to present this traveling museum of racing history. You know, it wasn't that many years ago that he raced just one car and changed it out to dirt fastball, set up the fastest car and the most daring driver here in Milwaukee. The rules were much less clearly defined, and human ingenuity and adaptability were really paramount. Now we wind up this short excursion into the past. Big wave of the 9th of the event. Midwest Old-Timers Fitted Race Car Club would like to thank our friends here at Tri-State Speedway for their hospitality year after year. Out there, of course, time to get great racing exhibitions for simply not too long. But thank you all. We truly hope you've enjoyed our portion of the program, our traveling museum of motor racing history. Remember, as one old racer once said, the fountain of youth is filled with tenfold glory. Thanks a lot, everybody, and wish you a very joyous and restful Independence Day weekend. Thanks very much.